Good morning and welcome to June. We are in June and at last it is feeling summertime here in the UK. We've been waiting and waiting for our summer and it's finally here, rather late. So let's have a look at your June tarot scopes. We're going to be starting off with the fire signs. So Aries, Leo and Sagittarius, that's the other one. So let's have a look. I'm just going to angle the camera a bit better so you can see. Okay, so Aries Festival, let's see what's going on for you for the month of June. We're going to be looking at your money, we're going to be looking at your home life, we're going to be looking at just general everything for you, Aries. Okay, can you see this as I put this down? Aries. I don't think you can. There we go, that's a bit better, isn't it? Okay, Aries. So, Aries, you start the month feeling fabulous. You start off here, it looks like there's a lot of abundance around you. It looks like things are starting to really feel a lot more secure. You're taking action around your workload, particularly and on your emotional side of things. And there feels like, you know, to do with work, it feels like it's going to start to pick up a little bit more. Things are going to start to get busier for you, Aries. There's some new ideas that are coming in, I can see here, that's going to start to take off. Particularly those that are self-employed here, looks very good. This month for you, Aries. If you are thinking about a new business, if you are thinking about doing something new, Aries, I would say yes to it. I would say yes, it's going to have some good financial benefits to it there. Security-wise around your home, Aries, it looks fabulous as well. It does look like there could be some change coming in around your home. So there could be some house moves or some things where the energy is just quite active in the home area there. Maybe you're decorating or maybe someone's moving out or moving in, but there's a little bit of change there. But it is good. It is good. I love it. Now, predominantly here, it is about your security in your home and your work life. So it is going to feel, you are going to start to feel a lot more secure. Secure? You're going to feel secure this month, Aries. Your love life, it feels like where things may have started off a little bit rocky emotionally, where things may be a little bit out of balance there, you know, not too bad, but a little bit out of balance. It feels like your love life, Aries, you've got to start putting some energy into it. So making time for date nights, we can get out now, can't we? Making time for some date nights, making time for some special time between you two. But there should be some good news coming in around your romance this month, Aries. And it certainly ends on an emotional high as you come to the end of the month. It feels like there's a lot more creative energy coming in. There's some happy surprises coming in there. And it feels like there's a coming together all round in your love life area there. So things should start to perk up a little bit in June for you guys, Aries here. Creatively here, it's very, very good. Spiritually, it's very good. I would say yes, now's the month that you're going to start to get involved with things again. You're going to start to feel that your creative juices are really, really flowing, and it certainly ends on a high. You start the month, Aries, feeling very practical, getting organized and sorting your finances more, sorting your security more. But as the month starts to move on, then you can enjoy life a little bit more. Things start to take a bit more of a fun turn there. Compatibility with people, coming together with people, and kind of realizing, you know, actually this is working with this person, or this is going well, and some good news coming in at the end. It's going to be important, Aries, that you trust your gut feeling, that you trust your intuition very much so as the month goes on. And you can start to make some very good financial business choices. It's like you're working towards things on a financial business sense there. So you could be getting some very good advice, or to do with the home, some good advice coming in to do with the home. I want to say, Aries, that there could be some happy family news coming in as well. Good creative news, happy family news, and very spiritually uplifting month for you. So there you go, Aries, that is your month of June's tarot message. If you would like to book a one-to-one with me, then do so on www.katemay.co.uk. Let's move in to Sagittarius, no, let's move into Leo. Okay. Leos. Let's have a look at what's going on for you, lush Leos. Okay. Leos for the month of June. Oops, we'll have a little look at that one. Okay, Leos. Now, you start the month, Leos, feeling a bit bored, feeling a bit stuck. I don't know if you can see this. Feeling a bit bored, feeling a bit stuck, feeling a little bit, not too sure what I want here. Things have been a little bit difficult, perhaps, for you, Leos. Things have been a little bit challenging for you here. But you are moving into calmer waters slowly. And, you know, you've got lifestyle changes here. So it's important, Leos, that you start the month with thinking, do you know what, the past is in the past and need to move forward. Need to start looking ahead rather than behind all the time. You've got a lot going on, Leos, at the moment. There's a lot of emotional things going on. There's a lot of mental things going on here. Now, I feel a bit stuck around your energies, Leo. So you could be feeling literally that you're stuck, that you can't go this way, you can't go that way. Can't move forward, can't move back. But having said that, trust your intuition because you will be able to start moving forward. I'm going to say as you come into the second week into June, things will be looking up a little bit more. You should be able to start seeing things a bit clearly and making more plans there. So I feel, Leo's here, there's some kind of apology or something to do with someone from the past coming back into your life. Maybe it's you that's got to apologise. Maybe it's you here that has to do the apologising to get things moving forward. There's a lot of energy around your emotional state at the moment, Leos. So you could be spending a bit of time in your head or spending a bit of time thinking, poor me. But, you know, there's always someone else worse, isn't there? So think of the cup half full, not half empty. Think of those, I always think, oh, you know, if I'm having a bad day, I always think of like, oh, those poor children or those just terrible places in the world. Then I think, actually, it's not too bad now, is it? But it changes your mindset, and that, Leos, is what's needed to do. You know, Leos, you are focused on you quite a lot. That's your nature, but now's the time to start thinking of other people. Now's the time to start really thinking about the bigger picture, but also bringing some of that fun back, Leos, because it looks like things haven't been fun for a little while. And you could be feeling a bit bored and fed up with that. But don't close the door completely because there are going to be some good opportunities. Now, I want to say, Leo, that there's also going to be some studying coming up. It looks like there's going to be things that you want to learn, that you want to study, and that you want to improve things in your life here. So there's going to be some opportunities. What you do with that is up to you as you come into the middle of the month there. But it certainly looks, I would take it if I were you, I would take it. You're trying to get a balance of everything, Leo, and some days it works and some days it doesn't. But there's some transition that's coming in around you, Leo, on a mental front here that's going to see you getting moving into calmer waters and having a bit more clarity here. Now, your work side of things, Leo, doesn't seem to be massively sparkly there or dull. It seems to be quite mundane, Leo's your work, so it may not be your huge focus this month. There could be more emotional and mental things that's got to be focused on this month, Leo, and sorted out really there. That said, I do feel that there is some positive work news coming in with opportunities and ideas, but you may just not be in the mood to take it or look for it there, but it is there. Think about studying, think about what you want to do in the future, Leos. Think about where you want to be in 2 years' time, and what you want to be doing and working towards that there. Now, mentally here, you are feeling, like I said, a little bit stuck, but it is one step forward, one step back. So you are moving into calmer waters. You've got to be careful that you don't self-sabotage yourself and block yourself, Leos, because, you know, you could be super headstrong there and you may have to be a bit more tactful. You might have to bite your tongue a little bit more than what you usually do there. But I do see here where you are going to have a lot of contemplation, a lot of reflection, and you're just trying to get a balance. And that's the thing that's important, trying to weigh everything and getting a balance, but also trying to have some fun. Now let's have a look at the card that jumped out. Interesting, the Six of Pentacles. So this is about fairness, and you've got justice there as well. So fairness, this is about give and take and doing it in a fair way. Now, sometimes this card can come up where there's voluntary work, where there is some money, a bonus coming in, paying off debt and getting a financial balance there. So that may be connected around you. But I'm also feeling here that it's practical things that you need to get a balance of. Having a word with yourself and being level-headed with things, getting an equal share and an equal balance of life in general around. That does include having some fun there. The Strength card here does bring you, by the end of the month, it says you've got the strength to be able to get through any challenges. You're leaving this past of those challenges behind, all those difficult times, that's now gone. You're looking ahead to the future here, but your outcome there, so the end of the month, you've got the strength to be able to get through anything difficult, but you may have to be a bit tactful, Leos. You might have to hold your tongue. You know, sometimes that roar of yours can get the better of you, so you may have to just rein things in a little bit and be a bit more gentle and a bit more tactful there. Overall, as the month goes on, Leos, I feel it will get balanced. I feel like your finances there, you might have money coming in and going out, but they're slowly starting to be balanced. And I'm getting here, there's a need to prioritise your money. So there's a need to have a look at all your debts, all what needs to be paid out. Try and clear some of that. Be sensible, be practical. That's not, Leos aren't the best with money, but now's the time, Leos, to get that sorted, really. Get your finances and get some kind of balance going on there. If there's anything legal going on, I feel it's fair. Some of you may be looking to move houses. Like I said, you want to be thinking where you want to be in 2 years' time. Some of you could be looking to move on from relationships or to be looking on from jobs here. There's certainly a change in the air coming on, but something better is coming up here that's going to help you emotionally as well. So look out for new opportunities around you, Leo. Look out how you can sort your money out. This is down to you now. You can't blame anyone else. Getting a balance, seeing what comes in, what goes out. Emotionally, you might want to take a bit of time out. You may want to have a bit of space, but try not to stay in that space too long because it won't do you any favours there. You need to be with people like-minded or fun, and it is on fun. Emotions need to be fun there. So if you're not having fun, you need to be thinking about how you can bring that in. And whether it's you apologising or somebody else apologising, accept it gracefully, give it gracefully there, but move on. This is a time, a month to be moving on, accepting what's happened in the past, but not to keep going over the past. It's not serving you, but to look more for the future. Okay, so that is your June's Tarotscope, Leo. Now, let's have a look for Sagittarius. Leos, if you want to book a reading, then contact me on www.katemay.co.uk. Right, Saggies. Oh, let's pop that up a bit. Let's have a look. Perhaps I'll put it back. Let's have a look, Saggies, for you for the month of June. It's just so nice to be in this summer zone. Loving it. And yesterday I went out in the sun and caught it, so I'm a little bit tingly. Okay, Saggies, let's have a look what we've got for you. I wonder if I can put that back and get the whole shebang in. Don't know. Yeah, that'll do, won't it? Okay, Saggies. June for you. Starts off with a nice comfortable card for you, Saggies. So this is indicating that you've got, you can't see that there, can you? That you've got control over things, but there's a need to be adaptable this month. Starting the month off being adaptable, which could be a bit of a challenge for you there, Saggies. You've got your own card there, which is nice. Okay. So all sorts going on for you, Sagittarians, this month here. Now, again, you could be feeling a bit stuck. You could be feeling like you're going around in circles, banging your head against a brick wall here. One step forward, one step back. And you may be feeling it's a little bit trying, that this month is a little bit emotionally challenged for you, particularly in relationship areas and particularly to do with communication of any kind. You're trying to stick up for yourself. You're trying to be you. You're trying to be your fiery self and get some order, and you're trying to be all regal with it, but it's difficult. It's almost like what's going on the outside is, it is different to what's going on in the inside there. You know, you are struggling a little bit there. So you don't like to reach out for help. You like to do everything yourself, but there is some struggles here. So you are going to need to reach out for help, I'm afraid, Saggies. There are people there though. You just need to get over yourself. Ask for some help. Otherwise it's just going to be more difficult. So you've got choice with that. Being adaptable is important this month, Saggies. There's a need to be adaptable. So you could be battling a few things, battling your mind, but these are just minor cards. So although they look quite they are just minor cards. So it doesn't have to be anything that you can't control or that you can't get over. I'm going to say it's going to be the next couple of months, Saggies, that you'll find some balance coming in. But as you move forward toward the end of the month, patience is really required, and doing things for the long haul, you're good at that, doing things for the long haul. So this isn't a quick 5-minute fix. This is looking at ahead to the future, but you are moving on. There's some financial benefit coming in, and there is going to be some help and support. So where things are struggling at the moment, as you move forward towards the end of the month, it's a lot better. You want to move forward, you want to get over things, you want to move on to the next thing there, but you are going to have to wait, you are going to have patience. But in that, while you're waiting, think about all the things you have achieved, think about everything that you've overcome, think about everything that you've done good for. You know, pat yourself on the back here. You've done all your good work, you can reap what you sow now, but it's just the waiting game of that next step. You've got a lot of choices around you this month. Your head could be swimming. Your head could be going round and round in circles, particularly with relationships and particularly with financial things coming on here, although the finances certainly look better as the month go on. I do feel, Sagittarius, where you start off the month feeling a little bit, trying to get that balance and feeling like I said, what's going on the outside to going on the inside feels certainly different there. But although you feel like you haven't got control, you've got choices with this which can help you be back in control. So don't fret there. There is emotional things going on as an influence here. So this could be you that's feeling distraught, or this could be somebody around you that's feeling distraught. If it's you, it's due to the action of others. If it's somebody else, it could be your actions. So there is some heartache there. We can't deny that. There is some difficult things. So you may have to reach out to somebody else around you as well and help them through a difficult time. It's all about patience here. I'm also bringing in Sagittarius healing around you. I feel that there'll be, so you know, I'm not going to say that you're all going to go to the doctors, but I do feel you need to be doing a little bit of a health check for yourself, Sagittarius, there. You're super stubborn this month, Sagittarius. It's so frustrating because you could help yourself. I'm going to say, you could help yourself a lot more than what you actually do. So some of this is going to be down to you, not, you know, just being stubborn and not wanting to budge, really. So being adaptable is going to be key for you. But you could get your knickers in a bit of a twist if you're not careful. So the Devil card here says you've got these choices. You've got choices here. This is choices around you. But you can be restrained, you can be controlled. But you have the choice to get out of something. Even though you feel stuck, you've still got it there. You can break free. You've got these swords. You can break free from things. Now, here there's restrictions around you which you're not going to like. So you need to be adaptable. Just have patience as the month goes on. Because by the end of the month, you'll be ready to move on. Now, pick your battles wisely and remember opinions of other people. So it's not necessarily right or wrong, but do listen to other people's opinions because it's going to be important, you know, to listen to maybe different points of view there. Let's have a look. So like I said, your finances here are going to start to improve. They start off a little bit tricky at the beginning of the month, but then there seems to be some financial gain or some celebration later on in the month that leads you to being in a better position to move forward. And this will also include your home. So some of you will be looking to move home and you'll feel better by the end of the month than at the beginning of the month about this. Emotionally, it is a struggle for you. So reach out to people. Don't be too stubborn. And remember that you've got choices with that there. But also have patience around something. Don't expect it to get fixed in the next 2 weeks. I would say it's going to take about 3 months for this emotional pattern to get itself sorted. Do respect other people's opinions this month, though. Weigh up everything. Listen to other people. Communicate. We're in Gemini season as well, so listen to others. Communicate well. Pick your battles wisely, but also remember sometimes an opinion isn't always an argument. It's just that, and it isn't always right or wrong. It is just an opinion there. Work side of things, Sagittarius, it feels like it's busy. Feels like there's a lot going on with work, and you may need to take leadership skills. You may need to take control of a work situation, but also being adaptable with what's going on emotionally with you. You know, your work is still going to be there. It's not going to go. So get yourself sorted first. And be mindful not to let anything consume you, not to let anything control you too much down a negative road. You know, if you get depression or if there's anything that just is holding you tight a little bit, then get free from that or try and work out a way that you're not controlled or going down a negative pathway. But overall, there's a lot of communication that's important, choices that's important for you, Sagittarius, but really it's about patience. and the long haul, knowing that you're, you know, these, like I said, this isn't a 5-minute fix of things. If things, if you're not feeling unwell, if you're not feeling well, then get yourself checked out, and maybe you have to look at your whole lifestyle there. Mentally though, guys, try and really think on the positive side, be optimistic, look ahead, don't look behind. And it's all about balance and doing things in moderation. Getting the balance of life, everything, work, finances, love life, doing things in moderation there. It's yin and yang. There's a lot of masculine and feminine energy coming in here, and just getting the balance of everything there for you, Sagittarius. Okay? It ends with you being in a position where you can move on though. You'll be ready to move on. You may have to wait a little while, probably until July, especially if you're moving house there, but things will become clearer at the end of the month. Okay, so that is our fire signs. Like I said, if you want to book a reading with me, then contact me on kate.may.co.uk. Have a fabulous June, and I'll see you next month.